girl is back. I'm back. And hopefully not going anywhere no time soon. For those who do not know who I am, you're new to the fam. Okay, you're new to the convos. Get comfy. Okay, my name is Michaela Jones. I am now a junior criminal justice student at the illustrious North Carolina A&T. Okay, I'm 20 years old. I'm from Pretty Girl County, and that's about enough. I miss doing case convo so much. So much has happened. Okay. So much has happened. So many reasons why I've been MIA. Thank you guys for all your support. Reaching out, checking up, staying up to date. Where have you been? I know that's what y'all was asking. What are you doing? Where have you been? And that obviously is what this video is about. Girl, where have you been? Okay, so to start off, of course, we are quarantined. The corona has took over all of our lives, okay?
I want to say one thing.
Okay, so that's one reason where I've been, okay? It flipped, of course, everybody's world upside down, but it flipped my world completely upside down. But before that, I really was struggling, like school, trying to look for internships, scholarships, personal life, you know? It was a lot. And starting a new brand, a new business, a new channel, just everything was so new. At first, I didn't have all the equipment that I needed when I first started Katie's Convos. I was still learning the ropes, learning about YouTube. It was just so much going on. I have joined so many orgs. I was fortunate to have so many stuff to become a part of, and I'll get into that shortly. So the good news and bad news of where I have been, it's a lot going on. Besides quarantine, I had a lot going on. I was stressing, school, finals, midterms, whatever you want to call it. I was going through all of the feels. Let's just kick it off and start with the good news, okay? Good news is during that whole period of time that I was MIA, okay, I was able to join so many wonderful orgs, get involved in so much with my second home community, which is the Greensboro community, because as you don't know, A&T is located in Greensboro, North Carolina, okay? So the things that I have introduced into my life, the orgs that I have introduced into my life, would be the NAACP. I was fortunate enough to be the Miss, and I am currently the Miss for my junior year, okay, for the 2020-2021 school year at A&T. That's huge. If you know me, then you know NAACP is the destination. Well, not the destination, but that's like a pit stop. Another thing that I was able to become a part of was joining the HBCU program under Bernie Sanders. It was an amazing experience. It clashed with my schedule, so again, so many conflict had me stressing, but nevertheless, very grateful for the opportunity that I was able to just engage with so many other HBCU students across the state, learning more about organizing, politics, you know, just things like that. That was also another amazing opportunity that I got. So in all, for that half, just really engaging in so many community service, so much getting more involved with my school, hanging out with my friends, of course, family, just really taking that mental break that we all need once in a while. On the other hand of me going MIA, I did, the world did experience a huge loss. Around the time that I stopped doing case convos, or when I decided to stop doing case convos, I actually was in the process of getting back. And then I had the unfortunate loss of my granddaddy. Place him right here. So Yeah, learning more about myself, about my family, it still is, honestly, a hard thing to cope with and to understand. To understand losing a loved one, to understand death, to understand grief, what it looks like, what it feels like, how it impacts a whole family, a whole community. It's been really tough, you know, dealing with the loss of my grandfather. That really was like, I was getting back. And then life was like, sitting back down. I was like, you're not ready. And I wasn't ready. And I did try to do things via Instagram and try to get back and create content about that. But it was too, and it's honestly still is, it was too fresh. It was like maybe 2 months or a month after it happened. I was like back trying to get in the swing of things. And it was a complete fail. It was a no. It didn't sit right in my heart to release the video, the concert that I did had. And I'll show you guys right here. So almost 2 or 3 weeks ago, I learned so much about myself. I learned so much about my grandfather. And I learned so much about mental health. So, you know, at K's Convos, I do everything under the sun because in our generation, it's so important to really have that open dialogue, those conversations, those uncomfortable conversations, the comfortable conversations, you know, all those conversations that we might have in our separate lives. I feel like it's so important that we bring it to one place, and it's an open space, it's a safe space. So that's where it really sat with me. Like, eventually when I got to that place where I felt okay to get back, I got back. You know, my grandfather loved K's Convos. He would brag about it to his exterminating buddies or his PMI buddies. He loved K's Convos. And so it really took some time to really sit like, hey, you know, he wouldn't want you to just give up the K's Convos away. Like, are you crazy? So yeah, he unfortunately passed away in January, and around the same time the world lost Kobe Bryant. So, and I wasn't a huge Kobe Bryant fan, but just to know that while I was grieving, the whole world is also grieving. You know, people lost a role model. People lost a father figure. His family, she lost her husband, her dad. And I guess knowing that two father figures were removed from this earth at the same time, like days apart, it just really hit even harder. So even when I thought I was ready, you know, after I thought I was done grieving, mourning, again, life was like, no. And I actually found comfort in knowing that, you know, people are feeling the way I'm feeling. You know, there's people out there that understand what you're going through. And it took a huge toll on me. It took a huge toll on my grandmother. It took a huge toll on my mother, on my uncles, you know, the whole family. And aside from the actual loss, it taught me more about myself as a person. I grew spiritually, mentally stronger, got more closer in my faith. It's a lot. Death is extremely hard. Experiencing a loss of any kind, friend, family, associate, it's crazy because, you know, the underlining question is, where do you go? What's next? You know, just not having that person physically there, but understanding that though they may not be there with you physically, they're always there with you. So it was something for me that was hard to understand at first, but something that I'm so glad that I understand, and I'm still learning. I also learned that grief morning is, it looks different in everyone. It's so different. There's so many highs and lows and lows and lows and lows, and maybe an extreme high, then an extreme low. Every day is different. Every week is different. Every month is different. There's, you know, one month you might be great. The next month is just like disaster. Like, it's truly a roller coaster. Grief is a roller coaster. It looks different in everyone. There's different stages. There's different feelings. It's just, it's really a lot, but I'm glad that I am in the point, I mean, in the space that I am now, where I'm able to share with other people my experience, because life is already hard enough. So just knowing that, and I hope people also know that Case Convos is that space, you know, like, it really is that space where we can have these conversations and ask questions and share experiences, because life is hard, y'all. Okay, like, we all know, we all experience our different highs and lows in life, but life is hard. Okay, life is hard. So just really learning about myself, learning about more about my family, of course, seeing how your faith can be tested in ways unimaginable. So just knowing that I'm not in the same space that I once was helps me under, you know, just keep going about my day, just keep moving and just keep thriving, keep believing, keep, you know, just keep pushing on, because the world keeps moving. Having a greater appreciation for life, for love, getting to experience the people that we have in our lives right now, you know, it just, it gives you a great sense of gratitude and appreciation. So that is that, you know. I still am not, you know, perfect, you know, of course, but I'm just so glad that I'm not in the state that I was before. And that's all you can, you just have to be grateful for that. You have to be grateful for your highs and your lows. You have to be grateful for the process. You have to trust the process. Okay, y'all? Trust the process. You have to trust your process. Double back. You have to trust your process. Your process. Your process. You have to trust your process, because your process doesn't look like my process. My process doesn't look like your process, but you have to trust your process. Whatever, however you feel those feels, you have to acknowledge them. You have to accept it. You have to be okay with those feelings, because they're valid.
On period.
It has been a journey this past, that whole gap of not doing Case Convos. And it wasn't all bad. Like, I know that must have, y'all probably like,
damn!
So just really taking my time, trusting my process. And then once I got into that space where I felt like, okay, I can do it, you know, I'm ready to get back. I have to get back, you know? I was able to rebrand Case Convos, give her a look. I see the look. Are we loving the look? Okay. And just really refocus and crack down on how I really want to go about with Case Convos. You know, how I want it to look, what I want to offer people. Just really, like I said, getting down into the definition and the mechanisms, the look, the aesthetics. Child, the aesthetics.
I don't like that.
But I'm so grateful to be back. I have missed y'all so much. This is just part one. This is just a brief recap, because I can't just pop out the cut like, hey, let's talk. And y'all like, but wait, where have you been? And then, yeah, so just creating and then also setting the foundation for transparency. You know, we can't have these convos if they're not transparent. We can't have these convos if they're not honest. We can't have these convos if they're not actual convos. These are real conversations. Really getting into what we need to get into, having those talks, having the uncomfortable ones, the ones that get swept under the rug. Okay? Just creating an atmosphere for everyone. So, with that being said, I am, again, so happy to be back. Thank you guys so much for the support and the love. Always sending me articles, sending me questions of what y'all want to see. And also, check out the shirts, okay? So, almost gave it away, but just having so much more in store for you all. I hope you guys stay with me, continue to stick with me. And until the next KS Convos, you guys stay safe, wash your hands, don't touch your face, okay? And stay tuned to the next episode, the next video of KS Convos. Y'all stay safe. 10,000 hours.